with that guy, just like me. You know, Andre Ward fight Kovalev, I'm going for Andre Ward. I mean, like Terrence Crawford fighting Americano, I'm going for Terrence Crawford. I mean, I'm gonna go for my guys just like they gonna go for their guys. So, you know, I respect them for that. And, you know, that was never distasteful. You know, of course, you know, sometimes I got booed and things like that, but it was never ugly or somebody saying something ugly and things like that. So, I have nothing but respect for them. And hopefully, you know, I win them over as fans too.
And you may not consider yourself in the role model position, but you have young fighters that look up to you. What would you say so they can take that attitude of keeping that chip on their shoulder?
I just said I'll never get complacent, because it's easy to get complacent, especially when you start earning money and start getting a lot of notoriety. And, you know, don't let, you know, stay with your feet on the ground, because, you know, when you're that top amateur and people are hyping you up and telling you this, and you win Prospect of the Year, and you beat people easily, you know, you can always get complacent and you know, stop training hard, or you get more money. Like Marvin Hagler said, he said it's hard to wake up. When he said something, when it's hard to wake up when you got, yeah, when you're sleeping on silk sheets, yeah, on silk pajamas. So, you know, you have to keep that chip, or you got to keep that underdog mentality. And that's what I always keep, the underdog mentality. Even if I know I'm going to win, I know I'm going to beat this guy easy, you know, I always, you know, psych myself out mentally where, you know, I just find a reason, either on YouTube or anywhere, I find a reason why. You know, I'm gonna train harder and focus and things like that. So that's why a lot of times when I'm fighting my opponent, I watch things that they say, and it just psychs me out. And it's like, man, I'm gonna punish this dude.
Errol, congratulations. My question is, out of all the fighters out there, regardless of affiliation, who do you think is the one that's gonna give you the toughest challenge?
Nobody.
See, I have to think, too.
I don't think nobody. I mean, Elia thought me and Mikey was going to give me a huge challenge. I mean, I guess I was just a big group or something. Just come forward, you know, but you know, I showed y'all a different element and, you know, a different game plan. So, I mean, I really don't know. Like, people are like, is Mikey Garcia your hardest fight? I was like, on paper he is, but I really don't. You got to ask me after the fight, because I really don't know until I get in there with him. So, you know, I don't know yet. I mean, the welterweight division is packed. I mean, you got Terrence Crawford, you got Sean Porter, you got Keith Thurman, you know, you got guys like Ugas. You know, you got a couple guys, Danny Garcia. So, you know, it's packed and it's a loaded division. So, I mean, you know, fight's going to be tough, especially if you're not on your A game. So, you know, with me, you know, my job is to stay on my A game, stay focused, and, whoever I fight next is going to be in trouble because I'm keeping my weight down now, too. So, I'm at way more heavy. I'm sitting around 160.